Hi guys, my name is Ole from Ole Aids Photography. Touring right now on a photo tour with one client. We actually having a great time. We haven't had a lot of sunrises and sunsets, but that's an entirely different story. You can well do without that, even if it's nice to get it. So I'm gonna show you one of those days, great sunrise actually that day, and we had ever-changing light throughout the day. We had sunshine, we had very cloudy, we had rain. And I'm gonna show you also the frames I got. Like I said, I'm going to show you one day of our 8-day trip, nine-day trip, and it was a nice day. We had nice light that day, and we had really, really nice locations. Most of the locations are really, really nice, but in good conditions, they are just magical. Remember to subscribe to my channel and hit the little notification bell if you want to receive updates anytime I upload. You know, like the video if you like it, and please share it. You know, spread the word for me. I appreciate it. We started off with sunrise on the glacier beach, the Diamond Beach, the beach close to the Glacier Lagoon, which is quite famous. Then we went to Eystrahorð Mountain, which is not as well known, but really nice. And then we ended the day at Vestrahorð Mountain, which is also a very well-known place, landmark place, beautiful place, one of my favorite. So, let's see what we got. We're here at the glacier beach, and we just had an amazing sunrise. The tide was kind of going out, so the seawater didn't reach the ice as we would have maybe wanted, but we just had to do different stuff. Today it came out great actually. It's, you know, just look at this place. You can't go wrong if you have a hint of an imagination. You're always gonna find something here. But to get this, we had to wake up like 4:30 to be here about an hour before sunrise. That's what you want. You want to get the twilight, not just the sunrise. And the good thing about that, when the sunrise is so early, that the lazy people, they're not there yet. They're sleeping. They will come after breakfast. But now, the magic is gone, you know. We're going to shoot a little bit more, and then we will go to our hotel, have breakfast, maybe have a little nap, and then we will continue.
Perfect day for the road. And time goes so fast when you're with the ones you love. But I won't worry today, even if time flies away, even if time flies away.
50 kilometers from the town of Höfn in East Iceland, Southeast Iceland, we have this mountain over here. It's called Eystrahorð, and it's absolutely beautiful. And the thing is that this mountain gets overlooked by many because it's kind of off the grid. It's just, you know, it's just at the highway, but very often just people drive past it because it's, you know, you usually won't find this in any tourist brochure or anything like that. It's a beautiful photography spot. You have those cliffs here as a foreground. You have numerous small ponds where you can catch a reflection of the mountain and the environment and the sky, of course. And it just offers a lot. So what's nice about traveling with only one client is you can experiment and you can try different things that you wouldn't normally do with a group, a big group. And there we are shooting now. We got this nice little pond with moss in it, you know, with a little polarizer to take the glare off so we can catch what's in the pond also. The waves splashing up and this beautiful mountain here in the background. So another frame we got now is right there where he's standing. This beautiful pond here in the foreground. Again, the mountain in the background. Just really nice. The fall colors are starting to show. So it looks a little yellow, and I kind of like that more than the green summer color. It's a little different, but. The frame was awesome. So sometimes when you finish the, well, kind of obvious frames, try to look for something different, you know. Foreground doesn't really, you know, jump up and scream at you. Sometimes you have to look for your foreground. And we actually managed to get this foreground over there. It's a small pond, huge distance from the mountain. But if you put on a wide angle lens, go really low and close like he's doing over there, it's gonna look huge. Esterhotten has been amazing. It's just a great place with so many photos. You can there's endless of possibilities. We have to go now because we're gonna do a sunset on another spot. But it's been great. If you haven't been here, you should check this out. You know, on your next Iceland trip or whatever, be here. It's great. So we're ending the day at Mount Vestrahot. You know, a well-known landmark here in Southeast Iceland. Beautiful place, absolutely beautiful place. You know, the mountains is just very photogenic, very cool mountain. And for foreground, we have these sand dunes, which are covered with grass. Now, it's a sunset spot today. The day has been very good with light. It has been, you know, we had sun, we had clouds, we had rain, and it's a typical Icelandic weather. You get a like sample, and in 1 hour you will get everything. So I'm gonna give, the chances are we're gonna get some sunset, some colors are about 50-50. So now we're at the beach here at Mount Vestrahot. Beautiful beach. It's kind of like the water It goes up pretty far, but it's relatively shallow, so you can basically stand on it. He has his waders on, so he can go further. There is no really use to go that far. After the water comes up, it goes back down and leaves the reflection. And also when the water is up like that, if you have a shutter speed about 1 second to shoot now, then you get a nice motion drag with the slow shutter speed when the water is receding again. It's up now. Now you shoot, get a nice motion drag, and it leaves the reflection. Beautiful stuff. Now we're here at the end of the beach, at the rocks here at the end of the beach, and there are some beautiful rocks there, you know, with green color because of, you know, mossy, slimy stuff and seaweed. And there are, you know, puddles between the rocks which you can catch some reflection and you know, try to find some leading line to the mountain. But it's, you know, like everything here, it's just amazing. It's so cool, this area, this place. And you can just get a ton of frames here, different frames, you know. You will always have the mountain background, that's why we're here. But there's so many different foregrounds here, just great. I hope you enjoyed this video. It was, you know, to give you an idea how a typical day is on tour, on a photo tour. Remember to subscribe and like and share. Give me some love. I appreciate it. Thank you. Goodbye.